Everybody, welcome back to our channel. I know we've been gone for quite a while, but we have a very great reason, and this video makes up for it.
And what's that reason?
Today, you will meet our precious baby girl, Peyton Elizabeth, right?
Yeah.
And we'll be showing you some details from our labor and delivery. So before we go to the day, let's just say I was so over being pregnant. I was doing everything to induce labor naturally. And how?
Like what?
Well, okay.
Like 50 different things.
Okay, so me and Skip, we did a restaurant tour. And the last restaurant of that tour, which he wasn't able to go, but I went with my mom and my sister, we went to this restaurant who is known for having a labor-induced salad. This salad, it's supposed to be like in the sauce, what really makes you go into labor. And there's so, like, people come from all over around the world to come to this little restaurant and have this salad to induce labor, like even celebrities.
And did it work?
I'm here. It didn't work for me.
Okay.
But there was this huge wall of people it did work for.
Okay. What else?
Well, I walked a lot. My sister had me walking in the park, doing squats. I bounced on my yoga ball or what is it? Labor ball or whatever it's called. What else did I do, babe?
Made me buy a video game. Just Dance 2018.
I was ready to dance her out. Oh, I tried that raspberry leaf tea. That really didn't work.
None of this worked.
Yeah.
None.
So when it came to the day, we went to the doctor's. It was about noon. We had a 12 o'clock appointment. Mm-hmm. We went to our doctor, and I was still only 1 centimeter, and I was, 3 days late. My due date was June 4th, and it was the 7th.
You weren't really that late, though. You swear you were like 3 weeks late.
I was so over it, though. I was so over it. And I was only 1 centimeter. So anyway, what happened when we went to the doctor?
Said that you could wait till Monday because he lets you go a week past. Mm-hmm. Or you're a good candidate for induction today. And as she said, let's do it today. I want to evict this baby.
No,
now.
Don't say that.
That's what you did. You kicked her out.
Don't say that.
Sorry,
stop
Peyton.
It.
I'm so sorry. Your mommy was tired of carrying you.
Oh, please. But yeah, he said, I can either induce you today or induce you in a couple days. And I was like, well, let's just get this ball on the road and get this little girl out. It's 5:24 on June 7th, and we are going in to be induced. Couldn't hold her anymore. Wave, babe.
I thought your bladder was full. Let's go.
So here we are at the hospital, and let's see, they gave me my first pill that was supposed to induce me because I'm supposed to take the pill first before they give me the Pitocin. It kind of like leads you up to the Pitocin because the Pitocin is so strong in the body. So they gave me my first pill at 7:19. It's called Cytotec. And the first pill, I really wasn't feeling too much. But I think I got my first contraction, what I thought I felt, was about 7:47. And they were kind of like mild. They weren't too bad. We was chilling. We was sitting in there.
She was eating ice chips.
Eating ice chips.
Thinking it was steak.
Oh my gosh, it was so good. Okay, so they gave me my second pill at 11:39. And contractions probably was getting a little tiny bit stronger, but we was still in a room chilling, watching Lifetime.
And
Lifetime.
Of course. Good. I don't know if Michelle wants any found out the other day that Michelle's pregnant.
This could be as comfy cozy.
This crazy.
We've been trying for so long.
We're here at 2 a.m. I've noticed that from 2 a.m. in the morning, I've noticed that these contractions are no joke.
Wait a minute, what time is it now?
It is 3:10. And
here we go, breathe. Breathe.
Just a few little techniques that we did to deliver naturally, because I really wanted to deliver naturally. And I mean, without like medication and stuff for the pain. What did we do?
We took some tennis balls and put them like in a stocking. Mm-hmm. And used them to kind of like rub on your lower back, mm-hmm, for like a massage.
Yes, we did the back massage. We did breathing techniques. Mm-hmm. We did the thing where Skip did like the two finger. I did the aromatherapy.
Didn't work.
It smelled good. Babe, stop.
It didn't work though. And you swore it was gonna make you zen and take me down. And she smelled it and was like, okay.
It smelled good though. But wait, Skip was nervous. I don't know what was wrong with him, but he spilled a little bit of the bottle. Like, he spilled it on my gown.
Didn't know if it was coming out or not. Couldn't tell. Then it all came out. And the aroma filled the room.
Ew, and we slow danced.
Oh, please.
That kind of worked a little bit. The pain was still crazy, but it really kind of took your mind off of the pain. So, I do recommend all those techniques. Maybe it'll work for you.
Alright, so after all those things, we try, the contractions keep coming because of the medication. So it's coming like every 2 to 3 minutes.
Yes.
And they were going for about 10, 15, 20 seconds at a time.
Yes.
And so I'm watching the monitor, it's like a little mountain up and then down, peaks and valleys. And I said, Ashley, if this does not stop for another hour, are you going to be able to handle this or are you going to need some assistance? And she was like, for another hour? I need the epidural.
And so the anesthesiologist and the nurse came in at about 4 to give me the epidural. Yes, I got the epidural. And because my contractions were like 2 minutes apart, they were ridiculous. And so they gave me the epidural. Everything got done around 4:10 a.m. And then at 4:20 is when it really like started to kick in, and with each contraction it got better. So right now I'm feeling good. I'm not feeling these contractions. It's like night and day, and I bless the Lord for whoever came up with this epidural. I could not rest. It was just, it was crazy.
I need the epidural.
It was the worst pain you'll ever experience. I didn't even say it like that. I was just like, yeah, I'm going to need the epidural.
Natural birth out the window.
Yeah. How
you feeling?
Okay. You excited?
Yeah, I'm excited.
Are you happy that my pain is over?
Yeah. Because aromatherapy, breathing. Ashley was saying this ain't working. But she did well. She pushed through and then she asked for the meds. Now she's like she on cloud 9.
And now you can get some sleep, huh?
Yeah, I can go back to sleep, I guess. I was alright. I've been sleeping a lot. I guess my body was preparing for this moment. So, okay.
I was feeling good. It wasn't too much,
drugged up.
Babe, why do you have to say that?
Because that's what you were.
No.
I just feel the pressure. I don't feel the pain.
Yeah. I think I was able to get some sleep, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, it wasn't too bad. And the pressure wasn't even crazy at this point.
Still eating ice chips.
My mouth is so dry.
Okay, So I'm back by myself because Skip had to tend to my little sweet pea. And so it's delivery day. It's June 8th, 2018. And they gave me the Pitocin around 8:39. At 6:13 a.m., they said I was only 3 to 4 centimeters, only 3 to 4 centimeters, and I was about 80% effaced. Okay, so they gave me the Pitocin around 8:39. I'm gonna say on the dot because I wrote these things down. And then at 10:55, about 11 a.m., they upped my Pitocin. So now everything is like really starting to move, and it's
my water just broke at 11:33 a.m. and I felt the pop, and I'm 6 to 7 centimeters.
Okay, so at this point, we called the family, which is my support team, which was my sister and my mom, and of course Skip was my support team, but the family came in. So at 1:50, almost 2 o'clock, the nurse checked me and I was 8 centimeters dilated. Like, things were moving. We was in the room chilling, watching TV, talking. I was so tired, but I was 8 centimeters. So they did give me the peanut ball and had me like in different positions with the peanut ball to try to get the baby to drop quicker.
So the nurse came in at 2:50 and she checked Ashley's cervix and she tickled the baby's head and Ashley was dilated 9.5 centimeters.
So the nurse came in and checked me at 3:10 p.m. and everybody, I was completely dilated. I was so ready. Sweet Pea is on her way and here we go. Everybody, introducing Sweet Pea, Peyton Elizabeth. Oh, look, her hands is
up.
Did I scare her when I said everybody? She's tired.
She just ate. It's time to go to sleep.
Yeah, she's sleepy. Babe, turn to the camera so we can see her face.
Her eyes are low.
It's okay.
She don't look like a drunk little baby.
No, she don't look drunk.
She do. She was like, what are y'all doing to me? Like, she's not worried about this camera.
So who does she look like? Does she look like me?
She don't look like Ashley.
My family. Everybody's been saying she looks like my mom and her sisters, so that's crazy. But I think she looks like Skip's baby picture too. Oh, she's sleeping now. Yeah, she's gone to sleep. All right, so I hope you enjoyed meeting Sweet Pea, and I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful in some type of way or entertaining at the least. Please like, comment, subscribe, and if you are subscribed, you are seeing this video first. So yeah, that's it. We'll see you next time with more videos.